The old method of ejecting the spin neo was to use the bottom and the upper tool. The way this worked is basically to take the upper tool, slide it through the side grips, and then put the bottom piece directly in the holes under. And holding this steady, you could either tap with your fist or a rubber mallet. Basically, you tap it down and you remove the bottom tool, and what it does is it breaks this thin membrane on the top, and it basically it ejects your model out. Now, this one has already been ejected, but let me show how that works with one that has not been ejected yet. Actually, I'll just show you how it works on the articulator without the model on it, so you can understand the process. So you put this under there, under the guides, and you tap this. As you can see, what it does is it breaks the membrane, the thin membrane on top. Now, in the beginning, the system was working fine. However, the spin neo now has been on the market for about 7 years, and one thing we've found is that there a lot of things can affect how this ejection process works. As you can see, this is not an issue because normally you'd have to take the thin membranes out and just remove them, but what we found occasionally there will be a fitment problem because of the various batches of the ABS plastic. Sometimes it just doesn't break cleanly, and you know, and you could have kind of pieces of it still sticking out. It's not a clean break. These are the things that can cause fitment issues, and at the same time the mold is also getting old. So it's a combination of a lot of different things right now, and these can be a problem in terms of having the dies fit properly. So what we've found, what we've come up with now is actually a better, it's a cleaner ejection process, but it does require an extra step. And the reason for the extra step is to make sure that there are no issues on existing patent claims. So basically what we've done is we have taken this center area here. This is a covered area where the pinholes are. And there are no thin membranes here. But we're using that same area to eject the stone, so we don't have to go through the sides here and cause problems. So the way this process works is we basically take ejector pins and put them in the center. Basically, it goes through the dowel pin holes, and it pushes this out. And the way to do that is basically you just use the upper tool, and on a flat hard surface you hold it in place, and you just basically tap, not too hard. It'll come out easily without having to break any of the holes at the surface there. Now, of course, these ejector pins, they come out, and at that point now you've got don't have any more fitment issue with this. I'll show you exactly how to create these holes in the bottom. Okay, the first step is to plan where your dowel pins are going to be. In this case, using this impression, I decided that the prep die will be right here, so that's going to be where that pin is. And then the other two, I just spaced them since I'm going to basically have three dies on the master side. So, having done that already, placing that there, what we need to do is find out where we're going to put that hole, the holes. Now, if you hold this up to the light, you're going to be able to see where the pinholes are. You can't see that here right now, but I will simulate that, and I'm going to put a little flashlight there, the LED light, and that way you get to see where those lights, where the holes are. As you can see, in this case here, this is where my first pin is because there's no light going through. So that's approximately where that's going to be. And then the other pin looks like it's right about here. So I'm just going to put a long line, just at least you get an idea where the pins are. And then the next one is right about there. So, yeah, it's about right. That's where it is. Now, all what you need to do is to know where you're going to place the ejector pins is to kind of somewhere in between. So what this is probably, you know, right about here is going to be a good place. Right about there. So right there, it's a good place. And then the other one, another good place is right about there. So if I can get this pen to work, there we go. Okay, so those are the areas where I'm going to put the hole. Okay? Okay, now I know where the ejector pins are gonna go. Okay. At this point, all I need to do now is just pour this model up. And once it's all done, once it's all poured up and the stone is set, that's when we're going to make those holes at the bottom. Okay, to make the hole, you're going to need a Dremel handpiece. Or lab handpiece, but anyway, this particular Dremel here has a special type of a burr. It's really a carving. It's a cutter, high speed cutter, but it does the job well for making a hole in plastic without getting it all gunked up. And it's got that real sharp point, so basically, it stays in place. For example, right here, if I was to determine that these are the holes, right? So basically I just need to do this, hold it in place, and turn it. Okay, so it's made that hole, and the other one right here, I also keep it in place, hold it in place, and okay, that did that there. So it's probably still got some stuck in there, but I think we might be okay when we get it over there. Okay, there you go. So basically, that's that. You don't want to make the hole too big because the key is to be able to get these ejector pins in, and you don't want them dropping out when you turn it upside down. And I'll show you how that works now. So have that one in there and the other in there. Oops. This one here, you could, on a hard surface, just kind of push it in. And the other one, do the same here. There we go. And what you need to do is basically push it down until it touches, and it's pretty much level there. So, take out this impression. Really should have that in place already. And at this point, you could use a rubber mallet or your fist, which basically ejects it. It ejects it cleanly, and you just need to remove this. You can remove the ejector pins. tight. Just take a pair of pliers, and that's basically it. So now you will no longer have the issue of any piece of protruding plastic or plastic deformity on the surface. And basically, it's a much cleaner method. Yes, there is that extra step, but after a while, it'll just be second nature. But it's a lot cleaner to do it this way. And we are making some design changes and improvements. So we are going to definitely have the ejection process a little bit simpler. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to call us. In the event you don't have a handpiece, a Dremel type handpiece, or just don't want to drill, here's another method to ejecting the stone. Basically, what you will need is just 3/4 inch finishing nails. And again, you go through the usual step of marking the place where you want the ejector pins to go through. In this case, it'll now be these pins. But you have to do this before you actually pour up the model, before you place the you already have to decide where the pins are going to be, obviously, and then take them out, and then mark where the holes are going to be. In this case, it's going to be here. And what you do is basically you just use a little hammer. Now don't push it, don't pound it all the way in. And then you take the second pin, put it in place. Now do not pound it all the way in, and I'll explain why. At this point, basically what you want to do is you want to just push it down. Now the if you will see, these nails are not flush, okay, and it's important that they're not flush. They just need to have a little bit more room. They're actually lining up with the pods, the four pods there. So the center piece is actually further in. Okay, so anyway, if you leave it like that, now depending on how thick your model is going to be, usually if it's thick enough, that's not a problem as long as the stone has set properly. But if it's going to be thin, I'd kind of worry a little bit, and what I'd do is I'd just trim off the tip there and just cut off a little bit of that tip. That way you don't risk going too high up and actually cracking the model in half when you eject it because of that pointed tip. Now, again, when the stone is over it, when you pour up the model and it's set, it sets around it, so when you eject it, it's not going to want to come out right away. You just wiggle a little bit and it'll come off. So it's not actually difficult. So let me explain what happens here. Imagine there's now the model there, and you put the upper tool, and the model's already been poured. And that's exactly where it is right now. It's not flush. But if you get a piece, something like this, where you can let this piece, the center part, go over. And if you, at this point, just tap it down, what you do is you force the finishing nails at the bottom to go further up. And that process actually ejects the stone. And at that point, it's going to be still clinging a little bit there, but just wiggle a little bit and it comes off. And then once that's done, you just basically push these down. So, and you can just eject it right here. That's it. These are the two burrs that I highly recommend for use in making the holes on the underside for the ejector pins to go through. Now the bit on my left is a Dremel bit, and you can see the shank is definitely thicker. It's a 1/8 inch shank, and the one on my right is a bit for the straight handpiece. Shank is definitely smaller, thinner, and you can't interchange these. This will not go on the straight handpiece, and this will not go into the Dremel handpiece. So anyway, this is the high speed cutter, and it's the 125. Okay, and the other one is made by Brassler. The model for this is the H219. That's H as in Henry, 219. I believe it's a cutter for vacuum formers. So anyway, but it's very effective on plastic. And the reason being is they both have this very sharp point, and it's nice because once you put it up against anywhere on the plastic, once you put it there, it stays. It's not going to move. And once it stays in there, it cuts with ease, and it doesn't doesn't gunk up. And the same with the Dremel bit. As you can see, it's also very, very pointed. And same thing again. Once you put it in one spot, it stays until it cuts through. So that's why I recommend both these bits.